Okay, so we in our previous module we have actually seen the diagram and base of diagram the entire structure was described. In this lecture we are continuing that thing, but here along with the diagram you will have some PPT slides before you, so you can match the description that have already been narrated before you. So the heading is structure, ultrastructure of centriole. So what we are talking about, the what does outer, well, let's talk about the outer boundary, cylindrical wall, cylinder wall, periphery. It does not have any membrane, so its wall, its outer periphery boundary is made up of what? Okay, so the most striking and regular, ultrastructural feature of the centriole and basal body is the array. Array means arrangement. Is the arrangement of 9 triplet microtubules equally spaced around the periphery, around the perimeter of an imaginary cylinder. If you take a cylinder and that's the imaginary cylinder, on the periphery they are equally, each triplet is equally distanced. So technically when you draw a diagram, ideally your space between adjacent microtubule triplets should be equal. Okay. Each triplet is also called blade. Immediately around the triplet is filled with amorphous electron dense material. Amorphous means shapeless, electron dense material means electron cannot pass through. So even it's denser for electron. So electron dense material. In the transverse section, the triplets, these blades are arranged like a veins. Pavan chakki jo kehte hain, veins. ब्लेड ऑफ द पिन व्हील और टर्बाइन, टर्बाइन में आपने देखा हो कैसे ब्लेड होते हैं, ब्लेड पे पानी गिरता है और टर्बाइन घूमता है. तो ये ब्लेड, ये ट्रिपलेट कैसे दिख रहे हैं, जैसे एक शार्प ब्लेड हो, जैसे एक पवन वेन्स के जैसे वो पंखे होते हैं, ऐसे लगते हैं. ईच ट्रिपलेट और ब्लेड इज टिल्टेड इनवर्ड, वो जो 9 ट्रिपलेट्स हैं दे आर टिल्टेड इनवर्ड टू अ सेंट्रल एक्सिस एंड एट द एंगल ऑफ अराउंड 45 डिग्री. With each blade, the tubules twist from one end to another end. Describe the helical. And ये जो है, ये D. Robertis में भी दिया है, P. S. Forman ने भी दिया है. ये description, ये दो line. Actually, what is called that? Your triplet. It looks like a parallel, but they throughout the length they don't remain parallel. At the proximal end, जहाँ से start हो रहा है, जहाँ से basal wall start हो रही है, origin center. They are at the origin. Sometimes they are more tapering. Instead of this triplet, they are tapering. So center में तो शायद parallel होंगे, लेकिन कहीं पे tapering भी होता है. So they taper. So sometimes this parallel, they don't remain parallel. Sometimes they are tapering. So and sometimes they also twist helically. But we cannot draw that diagram, and you can include this. This way, and helical course be they form. So you can say the triplets are this microtubule, parallel microtubules. You can say mainly these parallel microtubules form the wall of the cylinder and arbitrarily define the inside and outside the centriole. Arbitrarily means एक काल्पनिक boundary बना के रख दिया कि यहाँ से centriole का अंदर का हिस्सा है और यहाँ से बाहर का हिस्सा है. So they make the boundary, this triplet make the boundary of the centriole. Of the triplet ke andar ka jo bhi hota hai uske liye they use the word intracentrular structure, and outside this triplet they say pericentrular structure. This terminology you come across in many books, intracentrular structure and pericentrular structure. There are certain pericentrular microtubule structures are also, microfilamentous structure also there outside the centriole. That is called peri-microtubular structure, called satellite, basal root, and all that. We talk about them later. Then comes triplet. Then come the triplets. Let's talk about the triplet. वो तीनों का is what is triplet? So let's talk about this triplet. See, so A and B and C. This is one triplet. This is another triplet. So let's talk about this triplet. The nine triplets that make up the wall are basically similar in centriole and basal body. Centriole, basal body. What do you know? Centriole, cell division. Basal body is formation of the cilia. The three subunits of microtubule, three subunit or three microtubules or subfibers have been designated as A, B, and C. तीनों को हम क्या कहेंगे? A, B, and C. With the innermost label, innermost tubule being A. So innermost tubule is labeled as A microtubule. And their dimension, individual tubules, say for example A microtubule, B microtubule, C microtubule, individual microtubule are 200 to 260 angstrom in diameter, and their wall is made up of what? Tubulin monomer. So tubulin dimer, tubulin monomer. So that wall is around 45 angstrom thick. Okay. Only A tubule is round. The other are incomplete and C-shaped and share their wall with the preceding. That means B A के साथ जुड़ा है, C B के साथ जुड़ा हुआ है. So that's why it is called they are sharing their wall. The subfiber B share the wall of the A subfiber and subfiber C share the wall of the B subfiber. At both end, now this is the talking about the centriole. At the both end, proximal. So suppose this is यहाँ से centriole come diagram देख दीजिए, proximal है. So proximal and distal. So there are two end of the centriole. So at both end, proximal the C tubule often terminate before A and B tubule. So what does it mean? एक्चुअली ये टर्मिनोलॉजी आपको कब समझ में आएगी? जब सीलिया समझेंगे तब. सीलिया का जब मैं एलएस बताऊंगा तब आपको ये टर्मिनोलॉजी समझ में आएगी. एट इज कॉल्ड दैट एक्चुअली द स्ट्रक्चर कॉल्ड द सेंट्रियल बेसल बॉडी फ्रॉम विच द एक्चुअली सीलिया अरोज, सीलियम अरोज. ओके, सो व्हाट हैपेंड इन सीलियम? देयर इज ओनली टू ट्यूब्यूल, ए एंड बी ट्यूब्यूल, बट सी ट्यूब्यूल इज नॉट देयर. सो व्हाट इज कॉल्ड दैट? एट सर्टेन पॉइंट सी ट्यूब्यूल डज नॉट व्हाट यू कॉल डज नॉट असेंबल to form the long microtubule of the C tubule of the cilium. So there is a doublet, not triplet in cilium. So that in that context it is written that proximal end and both end A and B are always constant, but C may be terminate in between. Okay, so that is the context with the cilium. Then structure wise A, B, C are similar to the other microtubules. A tubule has 13 globular subunit around its perimeter. So 13, we have this diagram. These are the 13, 1, 2, 3. So these are 13 subunit around its perimeter. So this is the one entire A microtubule and it is a TS. So there are 13 such globular unit on its periphery. Three or four of these subunits are shared with the B tubule, which in turn shares several of its subunits with the C tubule. This we already spoken. Often triplets are thought to run parallel to one another and to long axis of the cylinder, but this is not always the case. Often, mostly they are parallel, but this is always not the case. In the basal body of some organism, the triplet gets closer toward the proximal end. They get closer toward the proximal end. So diameter of cylinder, that imaginary cylinder, sare nazdik aa rahe hain, sare triplet getting converged, like they are coming closer. So what happens at the proximal side of the centromere? The diameter get decrease. So cylinder get decrease. Cylinder ka pura cylinder hai, centriole ka, wo get decrease. Diameter get decrease. In some centrioles, the triplets are parallel to one another but run in long pitched helix with respect to cylinder axis. ये थोड़ा tricky है समझना. In three dimension, if you in certain, so not in general, but they also take a helical course. These triplets also take the helical course in respect to central axis of the cylinder. Then linker. What was the linker? CA link. We are talking about the CA linkage. Let's we are talking about right now linker. This third number ka heading jo kiska tha, we are talking about this linker. We are talking about this CA. Ye jo link hai, CA link ki baat kar rahe hain hum. This linker, CA. We are talking about this. Linkers. Okay, linkers. Linkers. The A tubule of each triplet. The A tubule of each triplet is linked with the C tubule of neighboring triplet by protein linker at the interval along their entire length. Okay, ये हमने डायग्राम में बताया. This linker holds the cylindrical array of the microtubules and maintain the typical radial tilt of the triplet. जो हम कहते हैं कि radial tilt है, it is more towards, it is tilted towards the center just because of these linker molecules, linker structure. In some species, instead of CA linker, there's a AA links are there. So adjacent triplets are not joined by CA linkage, but it's a rare AA linkage. And in other, in some is given here pseudo trichome nympha is a protist. यहाँ पे you find additional CC link in addition to CA connection. There is additional CC linkage also there. So these are some exception. Otherwise, the conventional typical structure जो हमने सेंट्रियल का बताया वो ही है. Parallel जाते हो nine triplet है, CA linkage. But और कहीं कहीं पे eukaryotic world में कहीं कहीं पे इस तरह के exception होते रहते हैं. Okay. Please. So, just one second. Linkers. So, there is CA linker, AA link, and CA connection. Then, these linkers are responsible for radial tilt of the triplet. Then, what makes the cartwheel structure? We say it's a cartwheel structure, turbine-like structure. So, what that is? So, cartwheel structure is made by the nine spoke. Just one second. Okay. So there are no central microtubule in the centriole and no spatial arm. When I will teach you the structure of cilia and flagella, there will be dynein arm on the one microtubule. But such structure is not there in case of centriole. However, often faint protein spokes, faint, they are not so much prominent. So often faint protein spokes, nine spokes are radiated out of the each triplet from a central core and forming a pattern like a cartwheel. So these are the nine spokes that actually give the cartwheel like structure. Cartwheel matlab jo aata hai na bail gaadi ka pahiya, usko hum cartwheel kehte hain. The central core also called the central rod or hub, and is 25 angstrom in diameter and without any microtubule, but may contain 1 to 2 longitudinal filaments. Central hub is made up of microfilaments. Each spoke is connected to a subfiber, how we have seen in the diagram. Such a cartwheel configuration determines the proximal end of the centriole and thus provide a structure from the polarity to it. We say yeah, polarity means actually the microtubules. Even in my previous lecture, assembly and disassembly, you already studied the cytoskeleton. You know it's a polar structure. At one end, microtubules are formed, and at the other end, it is actually removed. It is actually so disappear. So this is called polar structure. So this is provide this cartwheel structure is all this end where the cartwheel is prominent is called the proximal end. Thickening X is seen near the outer end of the each spoke. मैंने बता दिया क्या है. Why thickening? We are talk about. Another thickening Y is present in between two X thickening. The Y thickening is connect with the X thickening. ये जो पूरा description है, you will find very nicely written in the Veerbala Rastogi Cytology by Veerbala Rastogi book. So X thickening and Y thickening. Another thickening Y is present between two X thickening. The Y thickening is all connected with the X thickening on the either side and triplet on the outer side. The growth of the centriole takes place from the distal end, and in case of basal boy, it is from this end the cilium arose. जो दूर का हिस्सा है वहां से ही सीलियम निकलता है. जो दो एंड में से सीलियम निकलेगा बाहर उसको हम बोलेंगे डिस्टल एंड. ओके, ये डायग्राम बताता हूँ. सीलियरी ल्यूट, तो ये होगा मेन फीचर. अब ये दूसरा स्ट्रक्चर है जो आपके पीएस वर्मा वीके अग्रवाल के बुक में दिया हुआ है. डी रॉबर्ट इसने भी इसके बारे में लिखा हुआ है. एंड दैट इज सीलियरी रूटलेस, द स्ट्रक्चर नंबर 5. तो जो क्या है, सपोज दिस इज द सेंट्रियोल, तो सेंट्रियोल पे सीलियल का एक्सोनीम यहां से निकलता है. सपोज दिस इज द सेंट्रियोल, सो एक्सोनीम यहां से निकल रहा है. तो उसके अलावा उसके डिस्टल एंड में से कई बार क्या होता है, एक या कई बार दो इस तरह के स्ट्रक्चर निकलते हैं. तो दीस आर कॉल्ड रूटलेट, दीस आर कॉल्ड रूटलेट, दिस इज एक्सोनीम, एक्सोनीम, एक्सोनीमा. That is the part of the, it's a cilium, it's a cilium. Right now we are not talking about this structure, we are not talking about this structure. Right now we are talking about this and this structure. So this is centriole. So from its distal end, from its basal end, or its proximal end, क्या निकल रहा है? Two rootlets निकल रहा है. कई बार एक sperm species only one rootlet and sometimes it's two rootlets. There can be two kind, tubular rootlet or striated tubelet. Striated मतलब कि you know muscle fiber striation, patta patta, isme patte hain phir nahi hai, that is called striation. So that striation is also seen in this. So why, so there are two kind of there are two kind of structure, tubular root fibril. The tubular root fibril have the diameter of 200 angstrom. Striated rootlet, this striated, there are two, can be two kind of, it can be either tubular or sometimes striated. मोस्ट सिलियरी रूटलेट, जहां सिलिया होती है वहां से भी बेसल बॉडी में रूटलेट निकलते हैं. ये नीचे वाला स्ट्राइटेड हैविंग अ रेगुलर क्रॉस बेंडिंग, हैविंग रेगुलर क्रॉस बेंडिंग विद रिपीटिंग पीरियड ऑफ 50. तो ये 55 mm, फिर थोड़ा 55 mm का जगह छूट गया और फिर से रिपीटिंग यूनिट आ गए. तो दे हैव रिपीटिंग बेंडिंग ऑफ द रिपीटिंग पीरियड ऑफ 55 टू 70 mm, दे हैव गॉट बेंडिंग. एंड दिस बेंडिंग इज of the presence of parallel microfilament. Since this rootlet possesses within them microfilament, you find they are parallel bending. So this parallel bending are made up of what? They are made up of microfilament. These microfilament are parallel microfilament. The size is 3 to 7 nm in diameter, which in turn are formed of the ग्लोबुलर सबयूनिट. अगर उसके प्रोटीन को ढूंढने जाओ तो वो भी ग्लोबुलर प्रोटीन के हैं. आपने साइटोस्केलेटन में पढ़ा होगा कि माइक्रोफिलामेंट्स के प्रोटीन कौन कौन से हैं. यहाँ से मसल्स आर माइक्रोफिलामेंट, एक्टिन मायोसिन फिलामेंट, ट्यूब्यूल्स आर ट्यूब्यूलिन अल्फा एंड बीटा डाइमर. सो दिस यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडी अंडर हेडिंग ऑफ साइटोस्केलेटन, सो आई एम नॉट गोइंग दैट मच डिटेल. दीज फाइबर्स एंड फिलामेंट में हैव द स्ट्रक्चरल रोल सच एज एंकरिंग द बेसल बॉडी. बेसल बॉडी को अपनी जगह पे संभाल के रखता है, सेल के बाहर निकल ना जाए. ड्यू टू माइक्रोफिलामेंट सीलियर रूटलेट आल्सो हैव द कॉन्ट्रैक्टाइल रोल. एज मसल्स हैव कॉन्ट्रैक्टाइल रोल, सेम वे दिस सीलियरी मूवमेंट इज आल्सो पॉसिबल. द कॉन्ट्रैक्टाइल रोल ऑफ सम टाइम ऑफ द बेसल बॉडी एंड सीलिया आल्सो ड्यू टू दिस माइक्रोफिलामेंट. द रूटलेट मे बी डबल, दो रूटलेट हो सकते हैं एग्जाम्पल मॉलुस्क का, और सिंगल इन केस ऑफ द राना फ्रॉग में. एक फ्रॉग में एक ही होता है, एक ही रूटलेट होता है. नाउ दीस आर कॉल्ड द बेसल फीट एंड सैटेलाइट. ये थोड़ा ट्रिकी है. दीस आर एक्चुअली पेरी सेंट्रियोल के बाहर के स्ट्रक्चर है. दीस आर कॉल्ड द पेरी सेंट्रियोलर स्ट्रक्चर. दीस आर कॉल्ड द पेरी सेंट्रियोलर स्ट्रक्चर. वीबी रस्तोगी की बुक में इनको पेरी सेंट्रियोलर स्ट्रक्चर के हेडिंग में दिया हुआ है. पीएस वर्मा ने उसको एज अ पार्ट ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर ही दे दिया है. द बेसल just one second. You go through this slide for a while. Let's talk about basal feet. We will talk after one. Let's talk about the satellite. Satellite-like structure. Actually, they are satellite. There are two set. Each centriole is called that. Each centriole. These are one. Then well, these are satellite. Outer side to the centriole, there are nine. There are two set of such nine satellites. Nine crown. These are one set of one crown. These are one crown. It's called there. This is called satellite. So satellite kiska bana hua hai? Each satellite is made up of nine crown. Two sets of satellite. Ek, do, teen, char, panch, chai. And say nine crown, and this crown are attached with the triplet. आउटर साइड से सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द सैटेलाइट एंड एक इंडिविजुअल यूनिट को हम क्या कहेंगे क्राउन दिस इज क्राउन दिस इज वन क्राउन दिस अनदर क्राउन सच नाइन क्राउन मतलब के सैटेलाइट सैटेलाइट और पैर पे दिस आर पेरी सेंट्रियुलर बॉडीज आर इलेक्ट्रोडेंस स्ट्रक्चर लाइंग नियर द सेंट्रियोल देयर आर प्रोबेबली न्यूक्लिएटिंग साइट फॉर द माइक्रोट्यूबुल सो इट इज साइट फ्रॉम वेयर माइक्रोट्यूबुल्स न्यू माइक्रोट्यूबुल्स अराइजेस इट इज साइट वेयर द लेंथनिंग ऑफ माइक्रोट्यूबुल टेक प्लेस विद अ पेरी सेंट्रियुलर स्ट्रक्चर यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन योर हायर क्लासेस अबाउट दिस And these basal bodies, feet and satellite, basal feet are also such a, not shown in this diagram, are also such a pericentrular structure. They are actually arranged perpendicular to basal body and they actually cause the asymmetry. Structure is not symmetrical entire length because of this basal feet. We will talk about basal feet after we complete the cilia. Basal foot is a compound microfilament, but as I said, let me finish the cilia after. Will we talk about the basal feet in detail? It's a basal feet is actually the convergence point of the microtubule. To have this idea, actually you need to have a thorough knowledge of microtubule and microfilament. Actually, the point basal feet is actually a point where all these microtubules merge. Okay, so the focal point outside the centriole, periphery to centriole. So that is called the basal feet. And this basal feet also sends some of the its microfilament penetrating the centriole. So it's that detail you can sort it out. Thoda sort me karke sort you what you call you minimize that content and just write 3 to 4 lines. It will do at your level. So we are not going that much in detail. Otherwise, it will be a sort of MSc class. Now let's talk about the chemical composition. In exam point of view, आपको क्या लिखना है वो भी I will tell you. Chemical composition: the microtubules of centriole basal body contain structure protein tubulin along with the lipid molecule. So microtubule किसके बने हैं? Tubulin and lipid. The centrioles and basal body contain high concentration of ATPase enzyme. Why? Because actually the self assembly and self disassembly is going on. These are the molecules which are responsible for us. Aligning themselves. They make that assembly. That for that require energy. Unki assembly hone ke liye it require energy. So that's why they contain enzyme called ATPase enzyme. Then ye pH normal ki abhi bhi latest edition mein bhi isko barkarar rakha hai. That should be replaced. That's why this should not be added. There is a controversy. It's a 1971 research. Now it's outdated. There is no DNA RNA anymore. That's why I have given in the red line. There is a controversy whether centriole and basal body have DNA or RNA. No, it doesn't contain DNA or RNA. Function. Formation of basal bodies. अब इसके function पे आते हैं. कई बार exam में क्या होता है? सिर्फ function पूछ लेते हैं. Formation of basal bodies and ultimately cilia is a specific function of the centriole in the cell. एक तो cilia का generate करना. Second, नॉर्मल फंक्शन ऑफ पेयर ऑफ सेंट्रियोल इन मोस्ट एनिमल सेल्स टू एक्ट एज अ फोकल पॉइंट. फोकल पॉइंट मतलब जहां पे सब चीजें मिलती हैं, फोकल पॉइंट ऑफ द फॉर द सेंट्रोसोम. सेंट्रोसोम वन सेंट्रोसोम इंक्लूड्स टू सेंट्रियोल. द सेंट्रोसोम ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द सेल सेंटर ऑर्गेनाइज द अरेंजमेंट इज अरेंजमेंट ऑफ साइटोप्लाज्मिक माइक्रोट्यूब्यूल ड्यूरिंग इंटरफेस. अगर इसको सिंपल वर्ड में लिखना है तो हम क्या लिख सकते हैं, सेंट्रियोल हेल्प इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ माइटोटिक एपरेटस व्हिच एक्चुअली मेक द स्ट्रक्चर कॉल्ड द पोल एनहांसमेंट ऑफ द सेल एंड मेक द टू पोल ऑफ द सेल एंड ऑल्सो माइटोटिक एपरेटस हेल्प इन द डिटैचमेंट ऑफ द मेटाफेज क्रोमोसोम. तो आप सिंपल वर्ड में भी अपनी अंडरस्टैंडिंग से लिख सकते हैं, ये बुक के वर्ड ही यूज करना जरूरी नहीं है. समटाइम्स ये थोड़ा एक एक्सेप्शनल केस है, क्लैरिडोमोनास में टू फ्लैजेला रीअब्सॉर्ब जले जाते हैं, टू फ्लैजेला डिसअपीयर इन द बेसल बॉडी लीव देयर पॉइजन एक्ट एज अ माइटोटिक पोल. इनिशियली इट हैज गॉट फ्लैजेलम विद द बेसल बॉडी, देन द फ्लैजेलम आर लॉस्ट एंड द बेसल बॉडी एक्चुअली देन स्टार्ट हेल्पिंग इन द सेल डिवीजन. सो दैट इज द स्ट्रक्चर. इन स्पर्मेटोजोअन वन सेंट्रियोल गिव राइज टू द टेल फाइबर ऑफ द फ्लैजेलम. जो स्पर्म का स्ट्रक्चर डिटेल में पढ़ोगे एम्ब्रियोलॉजी में, सो दैट फ्लैजेलम इज एक्चुअली अराइज फ्रॉम द सेंट्रियोल, डिस्टल सेंट्रियोल. Then, centriole and basal bodies also found to be involved in ciliary and flagellar bit. As we said, it has also got some microfilament. Basal body also got, so it has flagellar bit. Centriole and basal body have a role in the reception of optical, acoustic, and olfactory signal. At certain बहुत ही primitive animals में ये cells जो होते हैं, उसमें they also has a sensory receptor. They act as optical. Optical मतलब आँख देखने वाला, acoustic मतलब सुनने वाला, olfactory मतलब सूंघने वाला. So optical, acoustic and olfactory signals are actually perceived by centriole in some primitive form at cellular level. It has been suggested that centriole ये 1983 में लिखा था कि उन्होंने एक hypothetical study किया कि जैसे कोई भी हमें रडार होती है तो कैसे सिग्नल को यूं पकड़ती है, तो सेंट्रियोल भी तो ऐसे ही लगे होते हैं कि एक एक ऐसा होता है, एक दूसरा सेंट्रियोल 90 एंगल पे होता है और ये सेंट्रोसोम इस तरह बनता है. तो माइट बी दे एक्ट एज अ जियोमेट्रिक डिजाइन, माइट बी हेल्पिंग एज अ सोर्स ऑफ रिसीविंग सिग्नल्स लाइक रडार. जैसे कोई प्लेन गया कि नहीं रडार में कैसे पता चलता है, ऐसे सेंट्रियोल. तो ये इनका एक है, ये पी एस वर्मा की बुक में लिखा हुआ है, लेकिन उतना मैटर नहीं करता आज के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में. सो दीज आर द मेन रेफरेंस. ये बुक में से मेनली कंटेंट आपका है और ये बुक में से है पी एस वर्मा ने पूरा जो अपना जो राइटअप है मेनली डी रॉबर्ट इसमें से लिया हुआ है और मेनली वी रस्तोगी ने कुछ एक्स लिंकिंग वाई लिंकिंग वाला जो है वो वी रस्तोगी अच्छा समझा हुआ है. वो जो डायग्राम है जो एग्जाम में आपको ड्रॉ करना है दैट इज मेनली फ्रॉम दिस बुक वी वाला रस्तोगी. दिस आर फिगर फ्रॉम द नेट्स एंड आई कैन डू वन थिंग, आई एम गोइंग टू स्लाइड वाइज सो यू कैन टेक सम स्नैप इफ यू वॉन्ट of this light. Then next slide. Then next slide. Then next slide. Then next slide. This diagram you are going to draw in your examination. This mainly this diagram and A, B, C, this way you can draw. One and two, these two diagrams should be there and entire write up. This diagram you can take snap. It is not required now. I think as you have though. This is also not required at your level. Then this description, cylindrical wall. Then triplet. Then this one. Then Tinkers. Then this cartwheel. Actually, cartwheel. It should be L is missing. Cartwheel. Let's again do cartwheel. Then fibers. That diagram of the ciliated rootlets. One. In one subspecies there can be one rootlet. In subspecies there are two rootlets. So that is mentioned over here. It's a basal body. Then ciliary rootlet ka diagram description. Then basal feet and satellite. This diagram is from the Wikipedia. Chemical composition. Functions. Functions. Reference. So here we have completed the structure. अगर complete कर लिए तो दो मिनट का मैं recap करूँ structure में क्या करना है. There are 9 triplets. You are drawing A, B, C. Each triplet is joined with other adjacent triplet by CA linkage. So you are drawing a one link, CAA link. Then you come to center, a central hub that is made of microfilament. From the central hub, there are 9 spoke radiate out. These spoke are give the cartwheel structure. This spoke before attaching with the A has the X thickening. Another spoke has X thickening. Do X thickening go? You are drawing another in V shape Y thickening and sorry V shape your structure drawing and at the V shape merging you point draw a point and you may label it as Y thickening. You attach that Y thickening with the XCA linkage. So that will be your structure and you describe about all these feature. So here my lecture ends and we can take.